Hello.
Hello, bon dia.
Hello, I'm Orlando Haddad.
I am Patricia King.
We are Minas. We're so happy that we got invited to perform for you. We're going to talk about the music and culture of the country of Brazil, the country where I was born.
So let's take this time and we're going to do a little bit of traveling to Brazil. We're going to learn about the culture, the language, and the kind of music that the people love down in the country of Brazil.
And as I said, I grew up in the country of Brazil and I have a lot of memories. It was a lot of fun. It's a country that's so different than America because it's a tropical country. The weather is warm most of the time. In fact, when it's winter here, it's summer down there. And so we travel to Brazil all the time. We bought lots of interesting instruments that we're going to share with you today.
So that percussion that you just heard was called samba.
Samba.
S-A-M-B-A. Have you ever heard of that word before? Well, samba is a popular music of Brazil. The rhythms originally came from Africa. But today, as you listen to the radio and you listen to all kinds of Brazilian music, you will hear the samba beat.
That's right. But there's another type of samba that got mixed with American jazz, and that's called bossa nova. Have you ever heard of bossa nova? We're going to play a very famous bossa nova song for you. It's a song called The Girl from Ipanema.
Well, what is Ipanema?
Well, Ipanema is an Indian word. It's a very famous beach in the city of Rio de Janeiro.
Rio de Janeiro.
Rio de Janeiro.
That sounds very exciting.
Or simply Rio.
Yes, a very exotic, beautiful place with lush vegetation, palm trees, all kinds of tropical fruits. And the song that we're going to sing for you, The Girl from Ipanema, is going to paint a little story for you to listen to about a young girl who's walking on, well, on her way to the beach, Ipanema Beach. And so we want to paint for you the picture to just imagine what the whole setting is to this song, The Girl from Ipanema.
Olha que coisa mais linda, mais cheia de graça. Ela, menina que vem, passa num doce balanço, caminho do mar. Moça do corpo dourado, do sol de panela, o seu balançar é mais que poema. É a coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar. Estou tão sozinho. Ah, porque tudo é tão triste. Ai, a beleza que existe. A beleza que não é só minha e também passa sozinha. Se soubesse que quando ela passa, o mundo inteirinho se enche de graça e fica mais lindo por causa do amor.
Yeah. Question for you. Was Orlando singing in English? No, no. What language would he be singing in? The language of Brazil, which is called
Portuguese.
Portuguese. Can everybody say Portuguese? So Portuguese is from the country of Portugal, but it's kind of funny that Portugal is in Europe. And Brazil is in?
South America.
They're just in two different places of the world. So how did that happen?
Well, the Portuguese were amazing sailors and they sailed from Portugal all the way west to Brazil. They actually got lost and they discovered Brazil.
That's right. So that's a long distance. So anyway, the Portuguese are a main influence in Brazil as well as African culture. And various European culture, and the largest population of Japanese are outside of the country of Japan is in Brazil.
Did you talk about the indigenous people?
And of course, yeah, we haven't, but the indigenous people, and we're going to show you some of their instruments in a little bit. So you can imagine Brazil's a great mix of people. We are going to do a song called One Note Samba. So as you listen to this song, try to imagine why it's called One Note Samba.
Thank you. hope has just come through. I'm about to be the unavoidable consequence. There's so many people who can talk and talk and talk and just say nothing, or really nothing. I give them the ball skill and all the yummy and I go to nothing, or really nothing. So I come back to life as well, as I close come back to you. Why?
Going to be talking a lot about Brazil today, but first we have to ask you the question, where is Brazil?
Yeah, where is Brazil? What continent is the country of Brazil in?
So, if you were thinking South America, you are right. How about some cities in Brazil?
Well, let's start by the capital of Brazil. Do you know what the capital of Brazil is? It's like the name Brazil, and you add an I and an A to it. So Brasilia, Brasilia.
So if someone comes up to you and says, what's the capital of Brazil? You can say, Brasilia. Of course it's Brasilia.
Yeah, and Brasilia, do you know if Brasilia is a really old city or a brand new city that is so young, that's younger than most cities you've ever been in? It's a young city. It's only 62 years old. It was founded in the middle of the continent of South America by a Brazilian president who decided that he needed to bring people to the interior of Brazil, because since the Portuguese discovered Brazil by ship, they landed on the coast of South America.
So you've heard about the other city probably when we introduced the girl from Ipanema, and she was from Ipanema Beach. And Ipanema Beach is in the city of
Rio de Janeiro.
And they call it Rio for short sometimes. And then the largest city in South America
That is large.
Yes.
It's bigger than New York.
It's called São Paulo. Can you say São Paulo? Very good. So those are the three major cities of Brazil. So enough of all this talk about Brazil and culture, and it's all a lot of fun, but I want to get back to the music. So let's do a song called Só Danço Samba. You already know what samba is, right? So what would danço mean? What do you think danço is, Orlando? Is he dancing? Is that
kind of slow, but I am.
That's samba's fast. It's got a lot of percussion to it. So it's called So Danço Samba. I only dance a samba. And we are going to invite you to sing with us in this song. And we're going to do what's called scat singing. Have you ever heard of that before?
Scat.
S-C-A-T. That means you're going to improvise. We're going to make up a melody and we're going to just sing it like jazz musicians do. When they're playing their jazz instruments and they're improvising, they're doing something like scat singing. So we're going to try that out with you. I'm going to have Rolando play the guitar. I'm going to make up a melody and ask you to sing it back. Can you do that? Okay, let's give it a try.
One. Two, one, two, three, four.
Papapeia.
Papapeia.
Oerere papapé.
Oerere papapeia.
Windi parapeia.
Windi parapeia.
Oerere perere papá.
Oerere perere papá.
Wipapena.
Wipapema.
Windi pa.
Bim, bim, bam, bim, bam.
Aí ele é papapeia.
We should try that again.
Yeah, let's do a little faster. Yeah, samba is.
And you can sing a little louder too. Yeah.
All ready? Right, okay, here we go. You ready? You got your voices warmed up. Okay, take a deep breath, and here we go again.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Weepin' boppin' day on.
Weepin' boppin' day
on. Weepin' boppin' day on. Weepin' boppin' day on.
Song, I'll hold my hand up and you'll know it's time to do our scat singing. But first, that was part one.
There's part two.
Part two. Do you want to tell them about
part two? Is in the language of Brazil, which we already told you what it is. It starts with the letter P as in Paul, and it's not Puerto Rico or Puerto Rico or Poland. It's or Polish,
Pennsylvania.
Right? It's not Pennsylvania Dutch.
No.
It starts with the letter P. Philadelphia? It's Portuguese.
Portuguese, the language of Brazil. Where does Portuguese come from?
It comes from a country. Another country.
Oh, Portugal. Portugal, it comes from Portugal. Well, Portugal's in Europe.
It is, and the Portuguese were amazing sailors, and they sailed from Portugal all the way to Brazil by accident.
They didn't
know there was this incredible land over there when they were sailing off the coast of Africa. The winds just took them away, and they went west, and they ended up in Brazil.
Wow, that's a long distance from Africa to
really
Brazil.
Long distance.
My goodness. Wow, so what were we doing again?
we were
getting ready to
wait. Yeah.
To talk about the words.
We're talking about the part two.
Yeah, part two. Back
so
to part two.
From a song So Dança Samba, and that's exactly what I'm gonna teach you. So dança samba. Can you play that? Sing that?
So dança samba.
So dança samba.
So dança samba.
Bye 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 bye. Ten.
Five. Oh. Five times.
I saw your hand do it twice, and five times two is ten.
Okay.
All but right. It's five.
It's five. It's five. Okay.
So dance samba.
So dance samba.
Bye.
Bye. One time only. So you're going to be able to just jump in and sing So Dance Samba with us. And when we're ready for our scat singing, I'll hold up my hand. And we'll do our fun scat singing. Here we go.
I'm going to play a little intro first.
Introduction.
So dança samba, so dança samba, vai, 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 vai. So dança samba, so dança samba, vai.
So dança samba, so dança samba,
vai, 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 vai.
So dance samba, so dance samba,
vai.
Já dancei o twist até demais, mas cansei, me cansei do calypso, tchá tchá tchá.
So dance samba, so dance samba, vai 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 vai. So dance samba, so dance samba.
Bara bara,
bara bara,
bara bara,
So Patricia, you've been to Brazil many times, about 40 different times. Wow.
I have. I love Brazil. I've been going there since I was 19 years old. I'm American and I met Orlando in college. So we started traveling back and forth to Brazil and we had family and continue to do so.
We take our kids down there and we visit family and we travel. We have been to the Amazon forest and we took our kids there. It was pretty scary actually, but interesting and very safe. You know,
it was scary because there was one of those piranhas. Have you heard about piranhas?
The piranha fish.
Yeah, those are the fish with teeth. So we didn't go swimming that day when we heard there were piranhas in the water.
No, I was actually in the water. And I asked our guide, I said, are there piranha fish in here? He said, yeah. I said, really? I got out right away, man.
So that's why we're here today.
But he said that they don't do anything. Can you believe that?
Oh, I don't know.
So the next song we're going to do is called Mais Que Nada. And it's a song that was made famous by a group called Sergio Mendes in Brazil 66. And 66 stands for 1966. That was a while back, in the last century, as a matter of fact. So, but the song has been brought back to life via a movie that many kids have watched lately. It's called Rio. Did you see that movie? Rio? There was also another one called Rio 2. So Rio is a movie that takes place in Brazil. The major character in the movie is a parrot named Blue. So hopefully you've seen that movie, and if you haven't, you should watch it because it's a really good movie. So here's the song, Mais Que Nada.
Oh,
So next, we're going to talk about the festival that happens in Brazil called Carnival.
Well, Carnival is the world's largest party. If you can imagine Brazil, which is as large as the United States, where the whole country goes into this big party mode, you have everybody in all the cities, in the town, in the countryside, everybody comes out for 4 days and four nights, and they celebrate, and they do that by getting dressed in these very exotic costumes, very similar to what you would see the mummers in the mummers parade, right? And all over the country, people go out, they dance, they sing, and they take months beforehand building these amazing floats where they have themes and costumes and a theme song, and they compete in this big, large parade all over the country. They each have their own parade. And it's amazing. They go down the streets and everybody's singing and dancing, thousands of people. So there's only two of us to show you what that's like, because they're all playing percussion. And so we are going to show you a little bit what that music would sound like, but you have to use your imagination and imagine hundreds of people are playing these instruments, going down the street and singing and dancing.
All right. One, two, three, four. Several instruments that we're going to tell you what they are and their names and everything. I'm playing a surdo, which is the bass drum, and the surdo is played with a mallet. You see, it's a soft tip, and it's played with the mallet and the hand. I'm also playing a ganzá, which is the shaker. And the ganzá goes one e and the two e and the 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 one e.
So this music is probably making you want to move around. So if you feel like moving, that's what you do. That's what this music is for. This instrument is called the agogô. Can you say agogô?
Agogô.
Two bells welded together with this stem here. The larger bell having the lower pitch, and the smaller bell having the higher pitch. So when I play the agogô, you'll be able to hear those two pitches going back in a samba rhythm.
Tell you about this little instrument here. It's called a tamborim.
Tamborim.
Tamborim. Tamborim, the word tamborim in Portuguese means little drum. It's played in a group. So we're going to play together with this special stick right here, as you see. It's almost like three sticks in one. Makes more noise, right? So when I was a kid growing up in Brazil, we made these sticks out of bamboo, which grows everywhere. And now they make it out of plastic, but they imitate the ones that we kids invented. So it goes like this. One, two, three, four.
Show you one of my favorite instruments. It's called the heco heco. Can you say heco heco? What a funny name. And it has a rhythm similar to the ganza. So this is how the heko heko sounds.
The pandeiro looks like an American tambourine, but it has a different name. It's called a pandeiro. It's played a lot different. It's played like a drum, like a conga almost, but it has this thing that you do with your hand that you go one e and the two e and the one, just like the ganza and the heko heko. One e and the two e and the one e and the two e and the one. But you also play the surdo. You don't go one, two, one, two, one. Like this, you go one, two, two, one and a two, one and a two, one and a two, and a one. So this is called a pandeiro.
Our last instrument is one of our favorites. It's called the cuíca. Cuíca, can you say that? And as you can see, it's like a round can almost, metal can. And in the front here, this is a leather skin head, and you can see a little string here that is holding a very small thin bamboo stick that runs to the middle of the drum. And Orlando has a piece of wet cloth. He's going to rub that stick, cause a vibration that will travel up the stick to the head of the drum and make a sound.
Played in the band, in bands together, and imitates animal sounds. As you've heard, it can sound like a dog, like a seal, like a whale. It can laugh, it can cry. It's a pretty cool instrument.
So these are our instruments that we wanted to show you today. And do we have any indigenous?
We do have some indigenous instruments. So here are some indigenous instruments. This one's made of seed pods from trees. That one too. It sounds like... Now this one is really made of coconut shells that are dry and it's tied together and they can make rhythms. Sounds almost like horses, right? Walking by?
Clip-clop.
Clip-clop. I played the one E and that pattern that I was talking to you about before. One E and the two E and the one E and the two E and the one E and the two E and the one E.
You want to show them the whistle? And while Orlando's getting his whistle, we already played this for you, but this is, they're called kashishi, but it's like a shaker. It's made out of sort of this, yeah, like they're woven like little baskets, and there's a coconut shell right here on the bottom that has seashells inside, so it's all very natural things inside here.
So this little whistle here made by Indians also sounds like birds and
the Baal Jeshuva. Look how big it is. Ah, I can get in the picture, right? And it's a rain stick. And it's full of all these kinds of little shells inside. And there are all these nails or thorns that are hammered inside. So they're like little pegs that the shells have to run through to make the sound. So here it goes. So it sounded like a little trickle in the beginning, and then it just sounded like a gush of rain. And that does happen in the Amazon forest. They have, huge events of rain where it's just pouring down. So that is a Baal Jeshuva, the rain stick. Song that we would like to perform for you is called Águas de Março, which means Waters of March, and it's one of our favorites. It has this little vocal dialogue going back between Orlando and I, and I hope you enjoy it.
It's a song about hope. Thank you.
mar, se fechando o verão, e a promessa de vida no teu coração. É pau,
é pedra,
é o fim
do caminho,
é um resto
de toco,
é um pouco
desafio, é um passo, uma
força, é um sopro, uma rã,
é um belo de sorte,
uma febre tensã. São as águas de mar, se fechando o verão, e a promessa de vida no teu coração.
Thank you so much for inviting us today to perform for you. I'm so happy to be here and spend some time with you.
Once again, I'm Orlando Haddad.
I'm Patricia King Haddad.
And we are Minas. You can find us on the web at minasmusic.com. So we invite you to visit our website. There are more videos and more recordings and things to see there. We also have a YouTube channel. What I wanted to say is that the word for thank you in Portuguese is obrigado.
Obrigado.
And when we say goodbye in Brazil, we simply say tchau.
Tchau.
So we're going to leave you with another percussion batucada. 1, 2, 3, 4.